No, I'll have to do some like last minute production work, which is going to be terrible, and you guys are all going to see it. But that's just to stop a million people asking, what's the score? And I know even if I do put the score up, people will still ask. It's brilliant. It really is brilliant. Anyway, this is a pretty important knife round. Whereas on Dust 2, I wouldn't say it's the most important one in the world. On Overpass, it pretty much is. CT is definitely the favorable matchup. And E-Frag are going to claim it with ease. So they will have the choice again here. And they want to switch to CT side. Nothing too surprising about that. I don't think this is going to pop up. So I'm gonna have to do it, boys. You're going to have to see this. You can feel free to flame me all you want. I wouldn't even be mad. You see that sick production work? You can't teach that. You really can't. I've tried, you can't teach it. So anyway, 1-0 is the score to E-Frag. You didn't miss anything. You don't need to panic in chat there. Still in the warm-up. Hey, Nyx, what's up? Yeah, it froze because I had to alt-tab to do the sick production work. Now, if people continue to ask what the score is, please give them a virtual slap from me. I'd appreciate that. Anyway, in we roar into the first round here of Overpass. Second map, E-Frag. And a huge advantage after that Dust 2 performance, not just in terms of the fact they're a map ahead, but the fact they brutalized TSM so hard. Maybe psychologically speaking, that's going to put TSM against the ropes, and Viktor is going to get caught in transition, trying to budge himself back to the side, get shot in the backside. And NKL now up from the spawn. He's going to try and do some work. Spyleader is there, though, to shut down Karrigan. The bomb, meanwhile, is being planted on the site. The CTs now have to try and land some headshots. They've retaken so many times, though, so far in this best of three. I would not put this against them. As Dreamer comes in, lands himself the headshot. It's on device. I think he's already given his position away on long. Can he pull off the sick play? They line up for him. 1-2! So nearly a third. But Bubbles there with the CZ. And he has enough time to defuse as well. E-Frag will claim another round, and you can't see the health again. I love you, GoTV. Marry me. There you go. It should be up now. Apologies for that. But Bubble does get himself two frags that round. A nice attempt at the end there. I don't need to restart GoTV, boys. You just have to press escape. If you ever have that problem, Uncle Vince will tell you. I'm Vince, by the way, for those of you that don't know. I realize it's kind of a poor choice of words concerning, like, who the hell's Vince? Uncle Vince will tell you, press escape, and boom, the health appears. Crisis averted. What's the map score? Great banter, the BCG. It really was great banter. Here comes dupreeh, though, up through short. Decides better of it. Bomb has been dropped, meanwhile, from TSM. It's no big deal for them, of course. Here comes the push, potentially from TSM, but they actually second-guessed themselves. Will be wrapping themselves through connector, which is a key part of this map. I'd be expecting to see E-Frag trying to occupy that in future rounds. There's no real point to play aggressive, though, when you know that TSM is going to have pistols. That's almost playing into their strength, which is close-range, close claustrophobic environments. So it makes a lot more sense now for E-Frag to play more passive and just wait for the inevitable push to come in. Dupreeh has connected in the first shot. Bubble really has made a mess of this one. Still gets three frags, though. How is that even possible? I thought he'd completely derp that. Feels good to be proven wrong, though, because that was pretty slick crosshair placement and indeed spray control in the end. And E-Frag come back in. I was going to say that TSM have no armor and no real hopes of holding this one off, barring a beautiful shot. And they weren't able to do either. So E-Frag are going to pick up the second round, but it is a bomb plant and three kills for TSM. All things considered, that's a successful round, I'd say, from TSM's perspective. They're going to be able to get AKs now because of that lack of force buy in the last round. So all things considered, a pretty solid round there from TSM. Yes, they lose, but they did a lot of damage on the way out. Yes, I met this. Specvoid, I think, asked that question. We want banter. Go watch Alan Partridge. You'll have all the banter you need. Oh my goodness, cajunb just got completely annihilated there in connector. Didn't even get a chance to really rattle off any revenge shots either. So he has to back away, tail top between his legs, 2 HP left to his name. And a really good start from E-Frag. So I said before, expect to see the aggression in Connector. They do just that. They do the damage. They back away. They would have heard that dink. So damage has been done here for E-Frag. Got a weird bug where it says alive at the top of the screen and it's like just 0 and 2. GoTV, sort your life out, please. If you have any more bugs, I may need a very quickly restart GoTV, boys, but I don't think you'll miss anything. I'll do it on an eco round if worse comes to worse. Just let me know if it's bothering you and I'll give it a quick reconnect to Reno. E-Frag, though, holding position on the B side. NKL's going to have that flashbang. Beautiful placed. One frag, very nearly a second. It was Cajun B with his 2 HP that was stood next to him. Now dupreeh goes in. Gets the drop on NKL. What is going on? Dupreeh with two kills. Looking for a third as well. Can't get it done. Spyleader will connect with a second as well. And just when you thought that maybe E-Frag had played themselves out of a clear-cut round, they are going to be bouncing back with authority. Well, have I spoke too soon? No, I haven't. Viktor with a grenade. And then the M4 frag to clean things up. Again, though, E-Frag lose three players, and it was a bomb planted for TSM, so they're keeping that economy ticking forward. Where do I live? In England. I'm not going to give you a specific address, because that's kind of a bit creepy. I'm just going to say England. I'm not going to kill you. Doesn't fill me with confidence, mate. Really? Oh, you're not going to kill me? Okay, here's my address then now. So because of the three bomb plants and kills that have came in, TSM can rummage together another buy. But this is pretty much maybe one of their last lifelines here before they have to bite the bullet and maybe go for a Techno and Armor half buy round. In fact, let's have a look at the economy. I'm assuming it's like $0. Yeah, they have round loss coming in. So if again they can get themselves a couple kills, maybe two or three kills on a bomb plant, that could continue these force buys going forward. But at some point they're going to have to tap out and maybe go for an AWP or full grenades to execute on a site. Because typically they're getting like a Galil in play here, and you can see a distinct lack of grenades. Four smokes is decent for a set play, but you need the flashes and the HEs and mollies as well on a map like Overpass. You really can force out positions like barrels, for example, on B, which you have already seen the E-Frag likes to go. How about your IP address? Brilliant. Taylor, what if I give you my address and my IP address? Do you promise not to kill me? Good stuff. I'll take your word for it, Twitch chat. You've never trolled in the past, have you? There's Dreamer, though, through the smoke again. He did hear the footsteps, and I think the smoke may be slightly too late. NKL, there's a small gap in that smoke, and he is making the most of it. He finally gets taken down, but again, TSM don't really have the time or the manpower to pull this one off. This would be more of a thrown round from E-Frag if TSM can win from this point. Just 16 seconds left. Device does connect the headshot, though. Spyleader is there, takes the bomb down, and that's pretty much lights out for TSM. They can't get this done now. And E-Frag will convincingly move forward to a 4-0 lead. No bomb plant this time for TSM. So this is going to be an eco, or best case scenario for TSM, a half buy. If they go for a full buy here, I'd be very, very surprised. Device saves the AK-47, of course. The rest of the team between 2.5 to about 3.3k in terms of money. So there we go. Yeah, it's going to be pistol upgrades with some Kevlar behind it as well. Finally, TSM tap out. Give up on this economic game of chicken. And E-Frag will be looking good for a fifth round here. Karrigan pushing in fast with a P250. Does get the drop onto Viktor, but only connects a couple shots, just drops him down by 45 HP. Not a terrible little exchange there from TSM, but they'd have been hoping for a kill, because not only would it have been a kill, but that would have dropped an assault rifle around short, which they could have picked up. It's like almost a double whammy for E-Frag there if they get caught out, but here comes the push, the pre with the 1D. The sexy plays are real, and that is going to be a bomb planted. And even though, again, E-Frag have the weaponry to retake this side, it's a bomb plant out of nothing, really. Just an AK and a Deagle with Kevlar behind it in this round for TSM. And it could get a whole lot worse, because here is Device. There's one frag, can't connect the second. The spray just slightly off. Both of E-Frag are low, however. What HP on Spyleader? 30 on NKL. And the bomb is planted in a precarious position, but Spyleader lands the spray down. He's going to just tickle the bomb and hope that it next goes peeking. And there we go, the peek comes in, and there's the frag. And E-Frag will have this one. And Spyleader has the kit. And there is the defuse. Another super close round, though. for TSM. And I feel like on another day, this could easily be like a 3-3, 3-2 scoreline in TSM's favor. Are you looking forward to Christmas? Yeah, I guess. I'm never a huge fan of Christmas, honestly, but it's always nice to see family. I live in the northeast of England, in Newcastle. There you go. That's as much information as I'm going to divulge about my address, bro. Can't we all just get along? It's December, it's a time for love. Not hate. That's right, let's light some candles. Get your lighters in the air, back and forward. Could be lighting a candle for TSM in this best of three if things continue to go this way. E-Frag playing the close angles. Viktor and Bubble is just behind him. This is giving up a lot of control over long, and that's a crucial frag right off the bat for TSM, but Bubble is here. One frag for him, looking for a second, can't get it done. And the CT's now dropping like flies. So TSM looks like they are going to break the curse here on Overpass, get themselves their first round. Light a candle for the NA, CS, and UK scenes. The UK scene is horrendous. Horrendous. Not going to lie. I'm from the UK. I should be biased, but it's horrendous. 5-1. The dream is real, right? What did he say his name was? Brad. So you want bot Brad to come sub in again? Really? I mean, he did have pretty sick movement, and the way that he caressed the door, you know, I was getting suspiciously aroused by seeing that play, not gonna lie. That might make me a bit weird, but it's alright. So anyway, back into the action. TSM hot off their first round here in the map. Could definitely start to get a whole lot more. Of course, the economy on the CT side, so much more expensive to consistently get the weapons out if you are dropping. And so TSM could easily turn this one back around. Again, I remember saying this a bunch on Dust 2. It didn't turn out to be the case, but the logic is there still, I feel. So taps coming through as a double stack pays out dividends for spyleadeR. He lands the shot. He was one of the best performing players for E-Frag on Dust 2. I think he was top fragging at one stage with like 20-11. And again, I was surprised by that. He's not typically the guy that you're expecting to carry the burden for E-Frag. But here comes spyleadeR, the man in question, frag, and the bomb has now been dropped. And now he's in a really good position to hold this one off, because TSM have to split their focus between bank and long, and NKL will just make the most of that. He just pops out, gets himself a frag, goes back in again. Beautiful work from Zipnex and dupreeh. Two kills back to back. That's all on Dreamer. He's got the first kill. The bomb has been dropped. There's 40 seconds. One of the only saving graces for dupreeh, because he doesn't even have armor. And he's been found out from E-Frag, who do just about claw on for dear life. And take the 5-round lead. And GoTV's like, bruh. Get kicked, son. There we go. Back into the server I'll go. Give me a second. Cheers, GoTV. I appreciate that, bro. At least it was nice enough to kick me at the end of the round. Is my mic from Aldi? Maybe. That's for me to know and you never to find out, bro. You didn't really miss too much. Just the one kill came in. Onto TSM, nothing I can do about that. GoTV kicks me. Yeah, you guys found out. I actually left on purpose so you guys could see I was Global Elite. I mean, that's some next level smooth operating stuff, isn't it? I was like, these guys are calling me Silver. Better DC so they can see I'm Global. Anyway, back into the action. 1 minute left on the timer. Although TSM did lose the first play, they've got quite a bit of real estate up mid. No aggressive play from E-Frag. Frag's coming through again. There's spyleadeR. He's just been on point this entire series so far. Viktor's in a good position. Goes for the spray down. Lands it. Zipnex is there to answer back. Can he go one better? Yes, he can. But there's so many CTs still alive. One of which is spyleadeR. He gets picked off. Maybe feeling it a tiny bit too much. The adrenaline coursing, surging through his veins. And he goes for that re-peak that could cost E-Frag dearly. And indeed it will. TSM pick up the second round. And the fact I just got added on Steam by a guy called Man Boobs and Bacon. pretty fantastic. That's a pretty fantastic name. Not gonna lie. Don't sound like I'm from Newcastle. No, I moved around a lot when I was younger. My dad was in the military, so lived across the world. But I was born here, and I live here again now. I have done for like 10 years, but accent went. Well, that's enough about me. E-Frag, go for the force buy. These are the kind of situations where I get a tiny bit worried for them. I can understand why they've done this, because TSM's economy is not great. The problem is here, if E-Frag lose this round, this could force them into at least one eco round. And this could be TSM pulling us back to a 6-4, 6-5 scoreline. So, I don't know. This force buy, very ballsy from E-Frag. We haven't really had a chance to see these so far because they dominated so hard on Dust 2. They were never really forced into a position where they had to think about force buy. The Dreamer just peeking up. Tap with that 5-7. First frag has gone the way of TSM. Well, spyleadeR Viktor with the spray finally gets his man with just 3 bullets left in the magazine, but easily able to reload and pull himself back to the site. Here comes the retaliation push though from TSM. Viktor's still there. Gets himself headshot from karrigan, who seems to be waking up right now. It's long Dreamer and NKL, and they may very well just save these pistols with the Kevlar. It stops the aim punch from coming in, gives them a bit more damage up close and personal than a USP would. And some of these ads, boys. Some of these ads, though. Dreamer, I'm not going to repeat what half of them are saying. Dreamer's there with the 5-7. And it stands to good reason from TSM's perspective that he probably would be around Playground. It would make the most sense. They'd already fanned out across the rest of the map. And E-Frag now into an eco. And even if they do fall on eco here, which they should, just the USPs, you can see their economy is like 1.9k. And this is right. Why I said, I don't understand why you'd go for that force buy last round. It feels like every single force buy is a risk versus reward, right? It's like, what can we get out of this if we win this force buy? Is there a chance that we can even pull this off? The reward there was far, far outweighed by the risk. If you win that round, TSM, likely onto a force buy themselves, because they know that your economy is weak. And if you lose, you're absolutely up the creek without a paddle and a gaping hole in the canoe. And trust me, it's not pleasant. And that's what E-Frag are finding out the hard way right now, as Viktor is going to get himself caught as he pushes up long bubbles there as well. Spray from dupreeh is good enough. But again, it's against full USPs. You're not expecting E-Frag to really get anything out of this round. A couple kills would have been good enough, but that's not going to happen. And TSM keep that economy ticking forward. Now the economy for E-Frag is mid 4Ks. So they can get themselves for masses. They can get themselves M4s as well if they so choose. I was going to say maybe they go for a couple for masses, but on the basis that their grenade's going to be quite low. But instead, they decide for full M4s. And almost an identical pickup here. Everyone with a smoke, a couple flashes, a couple nades. Here comes the push in from TSM. It doesn't matter if you don't have many grenades, if you get the perfect flashbangs off. That is the dream right there from E-Frag. The fact they got so many clear-cut kills off the start of that round is ridiculous. I don't even know how that happens. This is a beautiful pop flash onto short, wreck two or three players. Device is now trying to come up. He goes for the flash. I'm not sure if that was intentional or not, but the fact of the matter is that he pulled himself back as cajunb went in. So, almost feeding cajunb right into the slaughterhouse. 50 seconds, device with only a flashbang to his name. NBA flash. NA flash. You guys are ruthless. What device is hoping for here right now is just that they move position so that he can get that frag. The problem is that he's about to get flanked from Viktor. And I've got to say, E-Frag knew the bomb was there. So maybe moving both players wasn't a fantastic idea, but it worked out for them anyway, so you can't really hold it against them. I think what they're worried about is that device was trying to fake as if he'd rotate it through connector through upper, and they're a bit worried in case, you know, what if he drops out of upper and wrecks both of us from behind. So they end up moving regardless though. TSM back into another AK round, and E-Frag, you know, they do win that. You can see the damage was done. They still lost enough players to force them onto two for masses again. Not a great amount of grenades, only one defuse kit on Dreamer. Bot Vince. Bruh. NA caster. It's weird how many times people have asked if I'm from America, because apparently I have an American accent, but I don't see it myself. Or I don't hear it myself, I guess I should say. You can't really hear noise, can you? You can't see noise, I should say. Well, I suppose you can in some senses. I'm just going to stop talking about that. Stop digging deeper and deeper. So if TSM just play this round quite slow, I feel E-Frag will probably expend their utility fairly early on, and that pretty much is the case right now. They still have a HE, a Flash, and a Molotov. But a heavy stack on the A side from E-Frag. Four players there in actual fact. Just the one, which is Dreamer by himself, but the kills are going down. Bubble gets a team kill though onto Viktor. It's pretty rough, but takes us into a 3-on-3, and the over-rotation from E-Frag is called correctly from TSM as they start to push on in. The frags are coming in, Zipnex lands it onto Dreamer. Bubble and spyleadeR left. Bubble only with 17. Again, this is the issue. They don't have the utility to retake this site, and just simply don't have the equipment. As soon as I started to talk about hearing, like, noise and seeing noise, I was like, I really shouldn't carry this on, but my mouth just kept talking. So, yeah, feel free to lay the smack down on me in chat. I'd completely understand. Cuck the faster, am I right? You don't sound British. Okay. Caster actually reads this chat while casting. Mount Marilyn, I do indeed. I've already said before, though, some of you guys may not have been here. You're basically my co-casters, as I am solo casting this evening. You can probably hear my voice is going a tiny bit. This cast is terrible. Thank you, Impala TV. That is very generous of you. I love you too, bro. Rip Brad. Dream's dead. So E-Frag now, again, in a similar position to where we saw them two or three rounds ago, which is up against the wall. They did manage to fight back last time, though, so maybe TSM gonna have to try a tiny bit harder this time around. They have landed the first frag onto Bubble. The M4 with the Kevlar is still alive, though, on spyleadeR. But TSM looking good for a sixth round, and it could get a lot better from here on out. So we already talked at length about how great they are on Overpass, but their CT side in particular is absolutely ridiculous. It is super strong. So, 7-5 doesn't look bad for E-Frag, but I don't think that paints the full picture of how this map could very well go. Device can hear that movement. He must know that Viktor is somewhere around there. Could hear the jumping, and there we go. Does land the shot. Go TV, please. Switch over. Thank you. Sometimes you get the bug where it just looks at a corpse in third person for some random reason, and it seems that E-Frag are happy enough to just back away, look for a couple of exit frags of these USPs. But the main order of play here is to keep spyleadeR alive. He's the man with the M4, the man with the Kevlar, and indeed the man with the plan as well. And they will sacrifice themselves if need be for his life. NKL's taking damage through the doors, and he's going to go for the repeat, can't get anything done. And in doing so, E-Frag now down to just two members remaining. Dream has taken damage. In fact, he hasn't taken any damage. I'm sure I saw his aim just jump up there like he got tagged. SpyleadeR, can he hold on to the M4? No, he can't. He gets taken down after time. Brutal. And did my GoTV just crash again? I think it did. Don't you just love CS sometimes? In fact, it wasn't my GoTV. I think it was actually my Counter-Strike. CS, please. You know what's really weird, guys? My CS never crashes, and I'm not even joking, it never crashes. Like, literally never crashes. So just bear with me for a second. I can imagine that Twitch chat's going mental at this point. It's all good. Ripperino. Trashcaster. Silvercaster, lol noob. Keep it coming, boys. I feed off the tears. They're delicious. Come on, CS. Load up for me, please. We've got people that want to watch a game here. Hello? Boom. We're on our way back in. I can only apologize, guys. My game crashed. I've never crashed while streaming before this game. That is the truth. You can see there I'm on the loading screen right now. James DDoS me. It's possible. So it appears that in this round, TSM have been somewhat battered and bruised, down to a 4-on-2 as NKL will be pushing up the short right here, right now, as Device is going to get that frag. 28 seconds left in the time. A smoke across. Can't really discuss what happened earlier in this round for us to get into this position in the first place, but at least you guys are getting the action-packed moments here as Device, the good guy, puts down the cover there. That was super close to spyleadeR taking out his teammate. Device has to push through the smoke right here, right now. And indeed will catch out one player, still alive as well, using the smoke for the second time to pull himself back. This would be a sick clutch if he can pull it off. Especially as at a huge HP disadvantage. Famas spray comes in, again misses. The USP could be more than enough to pick him up. He's only 11 HP, but Device lands it. Four kills for him, a 2-on-4 clutch for TSM. And that could be massive. And my game is bricking its pants as it's crashed again. Hello, CS. Please, could you stop this? Again, at least it had the good fortune to let us see that clutch. I very nearly said something very wrong there out of frustration, but I managed to hold it together. I managed to just about hold it together. This is why I need a new PC, guys. Like, straight up. Jesus. Right, come on. PC, I believe in you. Can we have some hashtags pray for PC in chat, please? I think that's going to help. I think it's definitely going to help. Anyway, here we go. Round 15. For those of you that are staying with me, thank you very much. It's been a weird one. This evening, my PC is just not having any of it. But Viktor, I was going to say, he's in the right position. It's actually NKL. There's two players to his right-hand side in the connector. He's going to push through. Unfortunate timing. I guess he has to go for the information when you're on pistols, effectively. And Device all in by himself behind enemy lines in no man's land. Oh, Viktor. Don't do this to me. Okay, there we go. Karrigan takes him down. Pray for PC. Love it. Thanks, guys. PC is it's humming an acceptance, I guess. Maybe the fact my PC's humming is kind of a bad sign. Anyway, Dreamer. 1v4. No defuse kit, but does have grenades. Dreamer's still there. Really no hopes of getting this clutch. Yeah, he gets the first kill, but now they know exactly where he is. And TSM wrap themselves round, land the shot, and take an 8-7 lead. Which, considering that I think E-Frag started at 5-0. Yes, they did, as you can see there. 5-0, then 6-1 for TSM to bring this back to 8-7. Pretty impressive. So, Device, top fragging with 17-8 for the side of TSM, and spyleadeR 13-11. Second consecutive time that he is top fragging for E-Frag. Again, that's quite surprising. It's going to crash again. Why do you do this? My PC was happy. It was feeling good. It was feeling loved. And you have to go and say that. Biscuit man. Bro. Not cool. Not over till it's over. Very true. PC can't handle the trash chat. Yeah, I like that excuse. I'm going to use it. It's got nothing to do with me having a PC that's like 55 years old. It's purely because of chat. I like it. Nice stream. Ice for a cape? That's no fun. This pause seems like it's gone on for quite a long time. What's going on here, guys? There we go, they're ready. Because we're waiting for them to both ready up. Fair enough. PC's overheating, maybe. It could very well be. Honestly, I have... My PC's not great. I am going to be upgrading it pretty soon, because I'm going to be doing a lot more casts and streams in the future for a variety of places. So I do need to upgrade the PC soon. That's no longer going to be an issue. But unless one of you can send me PC parts through emails, then I think we just have to stick with this for now, unfortunately. Device, hello. It's a pretty sleek P2K headshot. I think they may have spotted the bomb as well, so that gives a bit of early information to TSM, but nothing too significant. With a minute and 20 seconds, easily E-Frag could find themselves getting through into the B side. And hold on a second. Cue the Jaws music. Dreamer, he's lurking. If he just turns to his left-hand side, he is going to have himself a frag and maybe two frags. He's heard the noise. He's heard the jumping. He goes in, lands the shot, switches to the USP, which, of course, is just so much better in pistol rounds. In my opinion, at least, I couldn't hit a cow's arse with a banjo with the Glock. And it seems that Dreamer feels the same way. Lands the second frag as well. And just like that, E-Frag have asserted dominance over on the B side. The bomb is still moving to A, though. So this is a fake from E-Frag. And it has drew out a couple players, but Device... he's going to be the first man to retake this site. Spots the player, misses the first couple of shots, and there's dupreeh, though. Locking down with the frags. Now pushing onto the site. Bomb was planted in the meanwhile, and both players scurrying on short side. One connector, and Bubble now in the toilets. The bathroom, whatever you want to call it. Landing the frags. Dupreeh is looking for one. The problem here is, yeah, you can assert dominance. You can try your best to land those frags, but you really have to connect them. And it's all on him. And he doesn't have a defuse kit. So this is going to go to E-Frag. There's no two ways about it. Even if dupreeh lands the one tap, it's still an E-Frag round. And he looks for the kill. Can't get it done. But Bubble will die to the bomb nonetheless. So E-Frag equalizes up. Please, no. CS, don't do this to me. Why you do this? Why? Oh, guys. I'm going to lose my mind in a second. Like, straight up. Let me see if I can close a couple of things here that may help. Let's shut that down. Let's shut this down. Let's brace my my butthole for the inevitable spam and hate on Twitch chat. Sounds good. Rip in pieces. Rip PC. Trash caster. There we go. Feels good. It feels good. PC's dead. Potato PC confirmed. I don't know what's wrong with it today, boys. I really don't. Oh, back into the server we go. My CS, honestly, my CSGO never crashes. That's the truth. I stream a lot on my personal stream. It never, ever crashes. Honestly, hand on heart, that's the truth. This has to be embarrassing. It is pretty embarrassing. I'm not going to lie. But I would say the word I'd use is more frustrating than embarrassing. I just closed a bunch of stuff, so hopefully that's going to help us. Either way, E-Frag. As you can see, it was an eco round from TSM, so you really didn't miss a great deal of that crash. But it appears that TSM are going to bite the dust, and E-Frag are going to keep all five players alive. Oh, it's not your fault that German stream has the same problem. So what is it, a GoTV issue? What's my personal stream? Just met this on Twitch. I'll probably post like hi or something in chat in a second. Well, not in a second, after this map. So if there's a problem with GoTV, then fair enough. It's a GoTV generated bug. It's not on your end. Okay, that makes me feel a bit better. I was thinking my PC was like actually dying. Roger that. Well, let's just hope that GoTV gets its act together. Here we go through into the 18th round. TSM starting to feel the pressure a tiny bit, as they currently reside at a 1-0 deficit in this best of three, and a one round deficit here on Overpass. But that one deke is definitely going to help matters, and the P250 frag from Device as well, now going to be charging through with the AK-47, nearly gets caught out, manages to switch across to his flash, then back to his gun, lands the shot onto spyleadeR. The bomb has been dropped in connector, and what about that for a turnaround here? NKL has enough time to react to that flashbang, can't get the frag though. But even if he does get this kill on Device, which he hasn't done, I was about to say, Bubble's on 4 with a MAC-10. So, maybe not the biggest deal in connector there from E-Frag. They're probably going to lose the round either way. And there we go, 9-9. Good, solid round from TSM. Bolsters their economy in the blink of an eye. Crash in 30 seconds. Please, no. Please, no! So, all 10 players with assault rifles in their hands. Dupreeh just chilling, staring at a wall. He likes the way it cracks and bends and... I don't know. I don't know where I was going with that one. Let's move on like nothing happened. Did I used to cast COD 4? Yes, a long time ago. That was like 6 or 7 years ago, at least. Here comes the force through, though, on the short. The smoke rushing through. Smoke's never the greatest of ideas, but they have got away with this one with two frags. Karrigan's back there, though. Spyleader looking for the cross through connector. And will connect enough shots to put down device. So he has been momentarily silenced, as has his teammate. But it's down to another one versus one. Spyleader definitely coming out second best. The Kobe from dupreeh. Spyleader catches that one in his pocket and is blown to smithereens. And TSM will take another round. Not in convincing fashion, just a one versus one. But it's a round regardless. And E-Frag will be in a force buy. And you know what? I am actually completely fine with this force buy. I give E-Frag a lot of crap for their force buys, but this one makes a lot of sense. They know TSM's economy is bad. They're on the T side, which of course is going to be easier to consistently get those weapons coming through and generate. The Tech 9 is brutal in the right hands. It's almost like a mini assault rifle in a lot of cases. But E-Frag have done the damage. The CZ works. Spyleader, what?! Dreamer nearly lands the dream headshot on Zimnex. In fact, he did land the headshot, but I mean the frag. What the actual hell was that? Spider-Man would have been content with those reactions. Jesus. Either way, though, E-Frag have found themselves a player behind somehow, mainly down to the fact that cajunb just picked himself up a double. The 1-2 combo is real, but... It's interesting that he'd be looking at short from the pit side. Feel like you're almost inviting yourself to get fragged in that way. Doesn't matter though, the rest of his team are there to hold down the fort, and TSM will win another one. Now E-Frag, I wouldn't like to see them force buy again in this round. I'd like to just see them tap out, say okay, no problem, but of course they're not. This is what I'm talking about. Like this in a nutshell, this round, I was saying this so often at the start of this game, E-Frag force buy too often, and people are like, yeah, it's part of their stats, their strats I should say, part of their tactics. I cannot see how this makes sense to me. I don't see the risk versus reward payment. Got such little grenades, they're just going to rush in, but TSM, it's the same kind of setup. Zipnex, by the way, that's beautiful spray control. But that's the same kind of setup that you'd go for on like a pistol rush. So TSM, all they have to do is play it the exact same way. It doesn't matter if they called that the force buy was imminent or not. They just played the exact same way, and easy round for them. So this is why I don't understand that play from E-Frag. Because now you see, it's not like they force buy and they can still afford weapons the next round. Like, now they have to eco. So, you're putting yourself further and further behind. The round loss will be coming in next round. So, they will be able to buy, like, a healthy buy. Can even afford an AWP if they're happy enough to go for that. But Bubble, the point that I haven't really made so far today is that Bubble isn't necessarily an AWPer in, like, the purest sense of the form. In actual fact, he does very much like to run with assault rifles as well. Often, you'll just see him playing AK or M4 instead of any AWPs on a certain map. Overpass is definitely one of them, so I feel I'd be happy enough to just pick up the full-on AKs. That being said, though, here comes the retaliation charge to E-Frag. They don't have many other options available to them. They only have Tech-9s with a Deagle and a couple of P250s as well. And TSM deal with that one comfortably. So they are moving towards that third map. But here we go. This is the buy I'm talking about. Are they going to go for an AWP? No, they're not. And this is not a huge surprise to me personally. They could have easily afforded one. Yeah, players in 6k, 6.5k as well, I think, but full AK-47 suits their playstyle a lot more. They're quite an aggressive mobster approach on T-side or E-Frag. They'll throw down the smokes and just charge in all five players. Not necessarily the greatest strat if you're going to have yourself an AWP or two. There's a flashbang. Nicely placed, but dupreeh is just going to absolutely put down the hammer and lands himself three frags. GoTV went ape again, so I don't think you caught too much of that, but dupreeh on point with the plays. Karrigan's there as well. Much more aggressive, much more confident play now from TSM. This is more like what I was expecting to see on Dust 2. Gmo with two pretty heroic kills at the end, but dupreeh's going to pick up his fourth and the 14th for TSM, so we could very well be heading to Inferno. E-Frag aren't going to have themselves AKs again. Dupreeh with a decent spawn. Thought he may very well push all the way up there, trying to get onto balloons or maybe peek off the fountain. Not the case. instead playing this one passively and slow. And it's probably the correct play, in all honesty. They went aggressive last round. You can see from EFRAG's positioning, they've got like everyone around this vicinity. They're playing for the aggression plays from TSM. So if TSM go in one by one, that's a surefire way for them to actually lose this round and allow EFRAG another opportunity to bounce back into this game. So the slower approach makes a lot more sense here from TSM. They've gone for the boost, which they haven't used too much, but it misses. They've got the first frag, and of course they know that players don't tend to grow by 6 feet in the space of a round, so another player is going to be there. The problem is that there was a smoke down, and therefore they couldn't see that second player, whether he escaped or relocated. And in actual fact, they have just bolstered up the bathroom defenses with two more players coming in. They line up! And I think that was Viktor who just did a backflip. I'll give him a 9 out of 10 for that form. Very nicely done. Unfortunately, you're still dead, sir. Dreamer now with 21 HP. Has been spotted. 35 seconds. Has the bomb. And doesn't look too good for him, does it? Oh, my goodness. Never mind that. What a headshot that is onto Zipnex. That opens up this round nicely. He still has a huge discrepancy in terms of HP. And he still seems to think this last player could be Bank on the CT side. And he's going to plant for the bathroom. That's so unfortunate. And he is going to end up dying. You can't really blame him for that. It really was a coin flip, a 50-50. But it turned out to be heads you win, tails I lose. And EFRAG are now 6 rounds behind. They have to win every round from this point onwards to take us into overtime. Very unfortunate for Dream. I really feel for him there. He's like, is he Bank? Is he coming up from B? No, mate, he's behind you. He just pulled your trousers down. Not like that, guys. Dirty minds. Device was looking, and he has gained the information he was seeking. A grenade just fell a bit short. Maybe he needs to hit the gym a bit more. I don't know why GoTV thought it was a good idea to jump into third person, but thank you very much for that one. Just in time for Viktor to get 2 kills. Please, sort yourself out. Looking for a third, can't get it done. And now TSM with a player lead, but EFRAG are going in for this one. They play it too slow, and cajunb will land the first AWP. He's looking for a second as well. Just about survives. Just about. But Dreamer has been caught now. They know where he is. And with a player on short and a player graffiti, this is a very difficult site to aggress on now. He does have enough time to try and play the mind games. I just don't think Dreamer's the kind of guy to do that. I think he's going to and try and rely on his raw aim instead. And he goes in, and cajunb is there. TSM pick up the second map, and will take us to Inferno. The momentum certainly in their favour. EFRAG looked unbeatable after that Dust 2 performance, but I said it before, I'll say it again. TSM are beasts on Overpass. That puts them at 23 wins, 2 losses over the last 3 months. Ridiculous stats there. So, to the third map we'll go. I'm going to take a quick drink, guys. For those of you asking, I met this. What's up, smaller gamer? I noticed you. I am indeed solo casting. And for those of you asking what my Twitch chat channel was, I will post a hi or something in chat. But for now, I'm going to put some music on, get myself a drink, and I would advise you guys do the same thing. We'll be right back.